So, welcome back to hopefully the last part of the budget planning setup in AEX 2012. So, we stocked yesterday here where we've created the template for finance. So, just say budget from my company, finance. View. We actually said that we just create one template just for finance and one for the departments. We've added here the facts table, so a hidden table in the end, which is actually just including all the different kind of fields somehow available. And we've added in here those which the user should see in the end. You also have an analysis table. You can actually do here whatever you want. Since it is just an Excel, you can say, for example, you want to insert the pivot table. And as you can see here, it is not based on a range, but it is based on a table, which means it doesn't matter how many lines there are, AEX will always have the full record set because the whole thing is a table. Good. So I can say, well, in an existing worksheet, and now I can go in here and say, well, I want to have in here, let's say I just want to see here the cost center name then, and let's say the actuals, the budget, and the this year proposed, but of course it should be the sum, and maybe in a nice format. So it's in the end just the normal Excel functionalities that you have in here. So of course, you can also add charts, bar charts, pie charts, whatever, but never use 3D pie charts because they are just looking crappy, looks like crap. So anyhow, let's also quickly add in the pivot table. Okay, a calculated field, for example, where we just want to, of course, it is not powered. Where the hell is it? Here, analyze. Okay, good. So, calculated field where we say, for example, last year's actual minus proposed from finance, and then difference between last year's actual and proposed. Good, and okay. And perfect. So you can actually add whatever you want in the end. Of course, you can then also add kind of charts, whatever. I'm not going to show that. I think it is quite clear what you can do. As I said, you can hide these kind of things so that this table is not shown anymore for the user. And honestly, I'm not sure about that. Let's try it. If we would go and say we are going to protect the sheet so that we say, well, okay, the only column that he is allowed to change are those two. So this one, let's try it. So I just quickly mark all of them. I say right click, I say format cells and protection not locked, and the same in here, this year to approved, and then as well format cells, protect not locked, and then I'm going to protect the sheet without the password, I would say. Yep, okay, and in here I'm able to change it. Okay, let's see if this is working. I'm as well actually not sure. So let's quickly going to save it once again. So I just click save as. And as I said, you always need to put it somewhere on such a folder. So on a drive where the AOS does have actually connection to it. Good. So I say finance. I just say finance template men. I didn't change anything from the one we did yesterday, but I just needed to save it once again. So I say here new. Good. Okay. Now the second one, so the second template. So we said, well, the departments they don't need to see the cost center actually because they already get it for the cost center. So they just need to see main account name, the amount proposed from finance, and the amount that they can propose. So this means nothing else than I'm directly going to I'm just going to override this thing then. So I use the exactly the same template. Of course, I need to unprotect it. I say department view, and let's quickly add, go here to the fields again. We said we don't need to have the cost centers. I'm going to delete the columns. Last year's budget is not important. Delete the columns this year proposed from finance and this year's proposal from the department. This one makes sense, and the other ones as well not. Good. And then again, to ensure, whoops, that just those are possible to adjust, which should be adjustable. Okay, and department view. In here, of course, I can say, well, okay, in here I do need a different analysis, for example. So I can also just go and say, well, I'm going to create the pivot table in. Okay, I'm going to delete this then, and I say here analysis. And I say here, well, I just want to see the main account name, this field, of course, not account, but a sum, and with a good number format, and okay, and as well, a sum, number format, number, and okay, and we are going to add as well in here a calculated field, which is called a difference, and we say this one minus this one, and we click on OK. Good. Let's add here as well kind of a pivot chart. But the sum of this, just say I don't need this one. I, of course, it's not possible this way. And if I say in here, insert. No, he's always connected to the pivot chart. I'm going to add it afterwards when I have actually data available. Good. You can always test it. So if you click here that so that the fields is not activated, you can always test in here if it is somehow working actually. So I just quickly save it as, of course, and to save it as not finance but department template. And if I just quickly click on refresh, we can actually check if it is at least somehow working. Don't worry about the filters, so we'll see actually in here all the data which is available in all different mandates, because it is set it up actually this way that budgeting over all different mandates would be possible in the end. So over the organization hierarchy, you can actually say, well, you also want to do the budget for each mandate separately with the different cost centers in there and so on. And therefore, in here, if you refresh it, you will have all the data as long as you have actually the rights to receive this data, because the Excel add-in is actually also having the normal security roles from AEX. So since I'm an administrator, I have access to all the data. If you just have access to mandate one, you will just receive the data from mandate one in here. And in the end, how we are using it, you will see it anyways later on, that you will have there just the thing or just the data from the document number. Great. So as soon as it worked this way that you have data in it, then it looks fine. Of course, those amounts are blank at the moment because we haven't done anything yet. So it looks actually perfectly fine. Good. In such a case, don't save it this way. Click again on fields and fields away, and then it's again blank. Save it in this form. So I just save it, and we have the two templates now manually created. Great. So let's move on to the last step. So back in AX, I'm going to minimize this, minimize this as well. And yeah, I changed the background color to an even nicer one than the yellow one we had yesterday. And yeah. So the last thing that we need to do is actually the budget planning process. What is the budget planning process? Well, it just defines what different kind of budgets you want to do. So for example, we are doing now a cost budget. So therefore, just quickly open it. So therefore, I just say, well, okay, I'm going to create here a cost center budget for this year. So cost center budget 2016. If you would have other kind of budgets, like if you would have beside the cost center budget as well a revenue budget, then it would be a new planning process because there may be other people or even other hierarchies included. If you would have a project budget, then it would be the same. You just need to create a new budget planning process and just do the with the new hierarchy and so on. So yeah, it is just saying which one it is, and normally you just create one for each year, because basically for each budget cycle. So in the end, yeah, you can then normally just copy the old one and use it if it didn't change. Great. So add the name, add the description. The budget cycle is not yet created. Yeah, we do need some kind of setups in here. Then I just quickly close it once again, and we go to budget control and budget cycles. So we need to create it in here just as well. A fiscal budget cycle. So from to date, it's not 2014. Just create one for 2015 that we have actually every year available. And I'm going to create as well 2016. And also 2017. Good. Okay. Let's go back to the planning process. Create it once again. Budget cycle 2016. The ledger is quite clear, so just your company that you need to choose. The attachment folders is just where should the filled out planning stuff be saved. In my case, I'm going to save it in here. As you can see, you cannot type in here something which is not available. You will end up in an error because AX is going to retrieve all the data which we've actually added in the budget planning configuration in the folder. So you just need to create it at first in here, and after that you can go and add it in here. Brilliant. So budget planning process administration, you need to choose the organization hierarchy. So the one that we've created in part one. So it is GLSI budget. Yep. And we have then, as we saw here, the department finance, which is the one which is responsible. In the end, this means nothing else than finance is responsible for the total budget. So if we go back to the nice background thing. So finance, so this is on department level actually, and this one down here as well. So department level in AX perspective, also department level in AX perspective, cost center, cost center, cost center. So department, cost center, and department, which means nothing else than on department level, we need to use, of course, the total budget workflow. On each of the cost center, of course, we need to do the department budget workflow. Quite simple. So the department budget workflow is just telling, well, yeah, the person needs to review it from the department and so on. And on top, so the finance created, which means afterwards the workflow is going to distribute the whole thing and so on. Yep. Budget planning stage rules and templates. Great. So we have here the different kind, so the two different kind of workflows. Means nothing else, and we can now say, well, at what stage should what template be printed if he clicks on the button in the end. So for example, or let's say, let's go for the total budget. So we do want to have the associated budget plans that he should be able to add lines and he should be able to modify lines. There are quite a lot of security things actually in here. But the initial one, of course, who is doing it? Is it finance or departments? I didn't edit the templates. So we need to go back at first to the budget planning configuration, to the templates, and click here on add, and then /\ax. Just need to have the folder. So, okay. We always need to add them in here, and I need to add both. So the department one, and I need to add as well the finance one. So just as a worksheet, you could add kind of Word files with justification letters and so on. I'm definitely not going to do that actually. Yeah. So, yep, back to budget planning process. And now we can choose in here. Great. I can't. And then we need to choose, is it the first one? No, the second one, finance template. Okay. The aggregated one, who is doing it? Well, it's of course as well the finance. So it's actually all of them is the finance. Of course, you can say, well, okay, after the department created, you can use another template where it is somehow different aggregated, however you want in the end. Finance review, the associated budget plan doesn't need to be shown anymore because it should be aggregated then. And finance approved, of course, should just show the total one, and it should not be possible to change it anymore, of course, and there, but with the same template. Good, the department budget, as soon as it is distributed, we can add it, it doesn't that matter. And the template this time is the department one. In review, they should be able to add the lines, of course, and modify the lines as well with the department one. And as soon as it is approved, they should not be able to change it, and as well the department ones. Scenario constraints, I'm not working with that. Good. Important is you can click then on activate, because otherwise it would not be working. Great. So we've created the process. The process is activated. We did all the setup, and now I'm really looking forward to see if it is working or not. As always, I'm also not sure if it is working. Great. So we don't have a last year's budget, unfortunately. Therefore, we are going just to create two scenarios based on last year's actual one. One is the last year's actual 1-to-1, and then we just say, well, the second scenario, which is last year's budget, which would be the last year's actuals times 1.25. So, okay, wherever you want to add a new budget plan, or if you want to add a new scenario into a budget plan, you can actually go over these different kind of functionalities. So for example, if you want to have last year's budget, then it would be here to generate from budget plan. So then you can take the last year's budget, which will be retrieved. If you want to have the actuals, then it is of course here the general ledger. If it would be from the fixed assets or from the forecast, then you can use those functionalities. In my case, I'm going to use here the from the general ledger, of course, which means the first scenario is, so as long as the budget plan doesn't exist yet. So as you can see here, in all budget plans, it is not blank. I don't know why it is not blank, but anyhow, so there are some budget plans in it because it is also a shared table then. Yes, it is a shared table. Um, Yeah, so it is overall actually. So yeah, there are some budget plans available, but not ours. So therefore, we use here then of course create a new budget plan. Don't do it as soon as you have the budget plan. You want just to add a new scenario because then it is different. Good. So we are going to create the budget plan based on general ledger. So actually based on last year. So based on last year's, we are going to create it. In the first part, I did some postings, so we should have some postings available. I can say from first period till 12th period, and as I also shown and now in the beginnings, and now it's the important thing, you can choose here just the account type expense as soon as you have it on the main account, as soon as you did it as I did on the main account in part one. Good. Historical. Would mean that he would actually create for each date one line. So in my case, I posted something on the 5th of May 2015, and I posted something on the 8th of August 2015. So he would generate for each of these dates in the end one transaction. Of course, I don't want to have it. I just want to have the full one actually. And now in here, you can choose the budget plan process, so the CC 2016 we've created, and now I'm then looking forward to Responsibility Center if it is working or not. Of course, it's not. I actually thought so. Which means, yeah, this is quite a nice error that you, it's not nice, a missing setup. I don't know yet which setup, but I'm going to search it right afterwards. So if you would receive kind of this error, or missing parameters. Okay, now not. So if you don't have in here something that you can choose, or if you receive some missing parameters, then something is missing. And I'm quite sure that it is on the organization administration on position maybe. Organization hierarchy, and I'm quite sure that in the budget that I need to assign a kind of functionality or position to the department. Positions, and now I'm adding a new position, job, and add here CFO. This should be maybe fine then. Let's try it. Honestly, I'm also not sure what it is. I had this error also in the first trial I had, and I just changed some kind of positions and then it worked. And now it's still not working. Yeah, I'll quickly pause the video and we'll quickly check it what setup is missing, but I'm quite sure it is something in the organization administration. So see you. Yep, okay. So it was actually quite simple. So it was actually exactly the thing that I did. So if I go here to the organization hierarchies, to my one, and if I go here to finance department, GLSI, then before I've added the position, yep. So I just switch to this view here. I've added the position, but what I forgot is you need to assign, of course, a worker. So this means nothing else than since I'm now in this, since I'm now assigned to this department, it will be retrieved then automatically. So the person who is doing it in AX needs to be within this department then, of course, because if someone from merchandising department tries to run it, then it would not be possible because he won't be assigned to this department, finance GLSI. Good. As soon as you did it, so it was just actually just click on you and change search for the worker, so quite simple. Good. So periodic budget plan generation, budget plan from general ledger, fiscal year from 2015. So you're going to copy the actuals from last year, so just the expense, historical, no budget plan process, and now the responsibility center appeared, so that's great. It can be, yeah. you don't have access to the budget planning organization because I am in finance actually, so therefore, good, budget plan, CC budget 2016, just the name and the scenario. So in which scenario you want to go and put it. So in my case, of course, it is the last year's actual. Makes totally sense. Budget class expense, of course, budget plan user group, definitely not. You can add now a factor. So for example, if you want to say, you want to use exactly the same information, you can say, well, okay, kind of accounts which have just one Swiss francs on it, you don't want to have, then you can put here two, and you can round it, for example, to 1000 or to 100 or to 10, however you like. Great. Create new budget plan. So this means if I click now on generate, I don't have access to budget planning organization that are included in the following budget plan process. Okay, a new error. So this means I'm going to check it. Okay, again, quite simple. I actually don't understand it why, but your system user needs to be in GLSI. So if I click here on options, and if I would, before I was in USMF, and when I'm in US, as long as I am in USMF, then it doesn't work. I think you need to restart it. So this means if I open it, then I would end up with the same error as before. Period 1 to period 12. Of course, now I am in USMF. Here it would work. GLSI. So if I, I think you trust me. So you just need to put here to tools and then to options, and you need to ensure that your user, so your system user, has the start company in which you want to start the budget plan. Honestly, not sure what Microsoft thought regarding this. Maybe, because it can be that one person is doing it for two mandates and separately, not over the hierarchy. I think they thought that everything is really always done over the hierarchy, and then, create new budget plan 2015, period 1, period 12, expense, not test, but CC budget 2016. I'm going to add it to the last year's actual, factor one, no minimum and no rounding. And I click on, not historical, of course. Last year's actual. And I click on generate. Good. So was generated successfully, which means nothing else than now I have in here, I do have my budget, also my budget plan. So means nothing else. Then in here, as you can see, he summarized all the things just on one date, because I said historical, no, I posted different kind of things on in May and in August 2015. He just put the actual on one date. If you can remember back, we are going to distribute it by month then in the end anyways. Good. So split it by the two, basically by the three departments, 94, 95, 96. And it is in the scenario last year's actual, last year's B and TJTA is of course still blank. Good. Now I want to add the second scenario. So this means nothing else. Second scenario, it would be the last year's budget, which means normally I would go here over generate budget plan from budget plan and would take the last year's approved. In my case, since we don't have budget figures from last year in it, I'm just going to add a second one from the general ledger. But it's actually exactly the same. Important this time, take not create new budget plan, create, update the existing budget plan scenario and append new data, or replace the existing budget plan scenario, because we are going to add it anyways to a new one. So it depends. Good. So this means nothing else. I'm going to use as well 2015, period 1 till period 12, expense. I say not historical, CC 2016 is fine. I'm choosing the document number, which is nothing else than the whole budget plan, and I'm choosing the scenario, in this case, the last year budget. And I just say here, well, multiply it with 1.25. And I click on generate. Perfect. And now if I click here in all budget plan, then what I see is last year's actual. I have here 10,000, 4,000 and so on. I can switch to last year's budget and I have everything multiplied with 1.25. Now, okay, but how are the people working? So as you can see here, it is the Responsibility Center Finance GLSI. Since I am a worker from there, if I would go here to budget plans assigned to me, then I see nothing for my organization. Okay, so yeah, I need to say for my organization. So all people from this department would actually see now this budget plan. If you have the enterprise portal, then you can also do it directly over the web over the portal, because in there you will have exactly the same functionality available as you have in AX. Great. Now let's see if the worksheet is working. So the normal process would be the guy is going in here, he clicks here on the worksheet, and could not be created because the template doesn't have at least one named cell. Contact the budget plan administration for help. That now is a problem. I am the budget plan administrator in this case, so there is something wrong. So let's just quickly going to check it. Yeah, okay. So it seems there is a problem with the template. I just quickly create a new one. So it is actually in the case you should not add kind of columns, so from metrics fields which are not available or have a zero value. So therefore I just quickly going to say here, I'm going to save it as into my folder, and I say new good, and I say fields, and in this case I just quickly going to add the cost center stuff and all the information again. So I want to have it here, so cost center description, this year proposed from finance, yes. So it is important regarding what you have. You have the last year's actual, the last year's budget, and this year finance proposal, but you don't have this one. So delete columns and CC name. Good. So I'm not going to protect it then. I just quickly close it and save it. And I think I didn't protect it, which would be fine then. Yeah, good. Oh, okay. Maybe a little bit bigger and a little bit bigger. Good. And saved. Okay, so we have a new template for finance. Finance first, actually, because we need to create the second template then. So this means, don't save it, close. Oh, not enough memory. Yeah. Okay, new. I think so. This one. Yeah. Okay. Great. So let's put then. We then need to actually do it once again. So we need to say here, of course, not anymore. This one, but we are going to add the new. Good, and budget plan process. Okay, he changed it already automatically. That's brilliant. But it is, I guess, just for the next one. Yeah. Cool. So, okay, we have now in the new template, we have three columns. So for last year's actual, for last year's budget, and for this year proposal of finance, which means also that this year from finance needs to have a value in. So it's not possible to have such a metrics column in it with a zero value. So you need to have also kind of proposal. So which means nothing else than I just say replace the existing budget plan scenario again from 2000 blah blah blah, and I'm going to say, well, okay, this year to approve is multiplied with 1.3. So we just give the finance guy a proposal and he can then override the things, and as soon as we clicked on generate, then he generated it. And on the budget plans, we have now all the three scenarios available. So we have in here, we have something, we have in here something, and we have in here as well something. And now let's try it again. Still not. Okay, so I'm just click again on this button. Let's see what happens now. Maybe it is working. Something else is working on blah 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 initial right now. Please try it later. Maybe it's because this definitely won't work. Maybe Excel was still running in the background. So I just quickly close the whole Excel. Yeah, come on, close. Good, okay. Processes. There is no Excel running anymore, hopefully. Okay. And this worksheet which was created, I'm also going to delete it on. Oh. There is still any kind of process. Okay, I'm just quickly going to look that I can delete this stupid thing. Which kind of process could it be? Maybe it is AX, maybe. So let's close AX. Yeah, it was AX. Okay, and reopen AX. GLSI budgeting, all budget plans, or the nicer way, not all budget plans, but the budget plan for my organization. And now worksheet, this message, he didn't create the file, he did create the file. If I open it now, Excel is running into problems with the Excel adding. If it keeps happening, disable this adding and check blah. Do you want to disable it now? And no. Yes. Yes, I want to remove. Yes, no, I want to remove myself. Yeah, what is he doing now? Someone else is working on blah blah blah. Okay, quickly close AX again, and maybe I really need to create a new budget plan from scratch. Let's see. So I'll just quickly create a totally new one. So a new budget plan, the same process. The second, I'm going to put it to last year's actual. I click on generate. I add all the three things. So I say replace scenario. I'm going to put it to this one, and I'm going to say last year's budget 1.25. I click on generate. Great. And the last one, I'm going to save. Replace scenario from 2015 into this year to approve. Now it looks even better with the scenarios. There was something strange before. And I say 1.4, because before I just had 3, and said, I can say generate. Good. Let's have a look at the budget plans. Let's have a look at the okay, I definitely need to check this because I don't know why it is now already approved. Yeah, I'm going to check it. So, okay, yeah, stupid me. I actually took the totally wrong service for the Excel template. So, yeah, let's create a new Excel template so I just quickly go quite quick through it. So I go to Dynamics AX, two options. Yeah, that's fine. Connect. The cost center structure, this is fine. And now the first time I took actually this one here, but this one is the wrong one. We need to take the budget plans. The budget plans for office add-ins just for the actually for the wizard. So the wizard is taking this one, but if you're doing it manually, you need to take the budget plans. Yep. So let's really quick go through it. So this means sheet one, and then here we have the backing sheet where we just add all the kind of stuff. So we add here document number, and then equal budget plan header dot document number, and maybe the preparer name. I'm just going to add this one here to really make it quite quick. So what do we want to see in here? We want to see the main account description, the cost center description, and we want to add in here metrics fields. So last year's actual amount, this one is read only, add conditions, budget plan lines, budget plan scenarios. Yeah, as I said, it is as soon as there is a small error, then it is then it is suddenly not working. And this was the case. Last year's budget read only, plan scenario contains is, and then last year's budget, then next total to approve, this one is not read only, budget plan lines, budget plan scenario contains it is, yeah, enter value, this year to appear TRTCC, so always the same TRTCC. Scenarios, budget plan is, enter value. Total, blah, 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 to approve finance. Budget plan scenario is, enter value, and okay, and final is read only, and not this one, but the budget plan scenarios contain is, and then this one, and okay, and we want to have this one at first, and this one, then total to approve, this one, and Then this one. Great. Okay. Yeah, it won't look that nice as before, but anyhow, the grid lines, let's take it away. Main account. As I said, you can delete everything in here. So, for example, if you don't want to have this one, or if you don't want to have this one and the document number as well, not, then you are able to delete as long as the valid field remains there. Main account name, CC name, and then those amounts, maybe a little bit smaller. Good. And in the backing sheet, as I said, you need to add all those which have such red stars. There are quite more than before, so this means red stars or such key fields. So also the effective date and all financial dimensions that you're going to use as well. And the quantity as well. And whoops. And I think there is one other one which is need to quantity, unit price. Yeah, the amount which also needs to be in. So this means this one here. So also beside those which are beside those which have a red X or a key field, you need to add quantity and amount as well. All the others should be then fine. Good. So let's try it once again. So I'm going to save it, and hopefully this time it works. So, test, just one template. Good. By the way, the wizard is working actually quite good. So I might try before with the wizard, and it actually worked. So you can also do adjustments later on, of course. So yeah. Good. Okay. So this means we've created a new template, which means we need to go at first to the budget plan configuration to the templates. And well, in here, let's just quickly remove those which I don't need anymore. Actually, none of them. And I'm just quickly going to add the real new one. So just one template. Good. And of course, I also need to put it to the budget planning process so that I say in here, I'm going to add on all of those this template, and as well in here in the second one. Great. So let's try it again. So we create again a general budget for a budget based on last year's thing, so historical no, and we say new trial last year's actuals generate is generated. I'm going to replace an existing one, historical no, document number, the new trial, the last year's budget 1.25, generate again, new, replace, no, and then the this year to approve, let's say 1.3, and generate, and generated. Good, all budget plans. new trial, and hopefully it is working. No, it is still not working. That's awful. Okay, let's do it this way. As always, and as I always say, it's not always the case that it is directly working at the same time. So yeah, so in the backing sheet, let's put it to B5. I have no clue if this has something to do, but let's just add every field which is available. From all the tables and subtables, because I actually think that AX does have kind of problems with kind of a connection somewhere. Yeah. So of course not all financial dimensions, but and also not those, but this one and financial dimension that we are going to use, which are cost center description, main account description, this one, quantity. And also this last table here, exactly the same. Maybe it was because of that, because I didn't add those three key fields, but you can then try it. If it works, but just by taking out the things, take away the fields and go back to sheet one, save it. Okay, next trial, close it. And again, this time again, a new one. No, not historical. New trial two and generate. And replace. And generate. I said historical, but anyways. And no, and this one, and let's see here, two, and generate. Yeah. Good, okay, and all that, budget plans, and new trial two, and now it is doing something, and now it looks good. Brilliant. Okay, great. Great. Okay. Now it worked. So as I said, you can hide here the backing sheet. Yeah, because this is actually not needed. Strange that it is empty. Did AX now add it? He added a table, but yeah. Anyhow, here it is. So let's try. So, okay, now we actually are at the stage where the finance guy is doing his budget, which means nothing else than those column is read only, this one is read only. Yeah, this is read only as well. Those he would be able to adjust. Of course, in the real template, you should take out those. Let's try to put it here, 3,000, here 12,000, here 333, here 500, and here 7. And if everything is working, then you can click here on publish, and AX should publish it then. You do not have access to budget planning organizations that are included in the following budget planning CC. Error found violating access rights are not sufficient to use this function. So it seems as if I don't have the permission to do it. Just quickly check it, and hopefully I'm going to hopefully I'll bring it to work today. But yeah. Okay, this was quite simple. Yeah, but as I said, you really need to do everything absolutely correct, otherwise it doesn't work. So let's try and put here something, here something, here something, and it doesn't matter at all. Now I stand it here, so if this cell is active and I click on publish, then this is going to happen. You do not have the blah, blah, blah. As soon as I am here and will click publish, then it actually worked. I'm honestly not 100% sure if I need to do it this way or if I need to mark all. Let's just quickly check. So actually now AX should have updated these kind of things. So new trial, and it was in this one here. So let's see what we have. 538. So let's 123, 321. And so, and if I publish it now, you do not have the access. Now I have the same problems. Aha, in here and publish. Records published. So you somehow really need to look that you were in here, but now let's check what AX did. Yeah, he updated all. So you really have to ensure that you are somewhere in the table available, otherwise it doesn't, otherwise it won't work. By the way, this one here, so if I try to update something here, you get this thing here, because it's just of the template, because in the template itself we added kind of things which doesn't exist yet, because in the budget plan we just have those three at the moment. The others will be created later on, and therefore, yeah, for those three there would be this kind of thing, so you cannot adjust it, of course. But okay, I think you understood how it would work. So the document number was taken, so he has just this one here, and I can go and say I can use all the actual Excel functionality, so I can say if and whatever. For example, somehow like something like this, and then publish. Failed. Click back in it, publish. And published. Yeah, okay. So, and now it is updated as well. Great. So, okay. This was it, what the finance guy did. So this means as soon as the finance guy is saying within his Excel, of course he can add any kind of pivot tables that he wants, so he can go and say, well, okay, create me a new pivot table, and I want to see how high is now the total amount by cost center, and maybe a second one, oops, a second one in an existing one in this one in here, where he want to see the whole thing just by main account and so on. So it's really now just a normal Excel sheet, which is actually saved in the folder that we described. So it's actually AX automatically created a new Excel file, which is in here. So this means nothing else, and I can save it, and I will would have it available as well. Great. So this worked. This means nothing else than also in here I would be able to make adjustments, of course. So just on this one that we said, on the other one they are grayed out. And in the end, when it is fine, I can click on submit and I can click on submit, and now it is in the workflow. By the way, you always see here if something is needed to do for the workflows. If I click F5, then it's not anymore. Yep, because it is now in the workflow. If the workflow is not running, means nothing else than yeah, that the workflow thing is not, that the workflow batch job is not running. And I've actually on my channel you will find, yeah, in here in the purchase requisition thing, I've actually showed you how to activate the workflow batch job. I think in the travel and expense as well, but yeah, just have a look at it. So if the workflow is not running, then you need to activate the batch job that it is running. So let's have a look. Click F5, and yep, as you saw, AX did something. So we had before the 21, and let's have a look at the history. And there was an error. And okay, yeah. Now it is important. So as you can see here, couldn't find user information for party, blah 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 blah. So this means nothing else. Then every user or every worker needs to have a system user as well. I had one, but Gisbert or Pamina don't. So let's say this one is Gisbert. Okay, and this one is Pamina, and okay, great, and then we can go back to the budgeting thing, to this one where we had the error, so view history, and then resume, and now it is pending again. In the meantime, until it is during this in the workflow, one other thing that I also came across, always check in the general ledger, in the financial dimension, so setup financial dimension configuration for integration applications, always ensure that the cost center and the main account, respectively, all the financial dimensions that you are using, that they are activated. Otherwise, you could maybe run into problems. Good. So let's go back to the budget plans. And now it looks better. Yeah, great. So we started at 21. And AX automatically created now the three new ones. So this means nothing else. The whole distribution is now automatically done. And of course, so if you check it out here, for example, you have the cost center 94, cost center 95, and cost center 96, everything available. In the purchasing, for example, you just have the 94, here just the 95, and here just the 96, of course. It also added the budget plan preparer, so means nothing else than I am one preparer. And in here, let's quickly check in here. So now, of course, in here, since I am the preparer, so basically this was a stop from the thing for the finance guy, so the finance guy can actually just go out. Good. Now it is distributed to the people. And another thing that I also did before that it is working is in the organization hierarchy, and then here GLSI budget view, and then finance department, and you really need to have each person, which is the cost center manager, needs to have a role within this organization hierarchy. So this means nothing else than you always need to add here the person that. Yeah, so basically you always need to add here the person for every position which is needed. So for purchasing then as well. So basically I just quickly edit and just quickly take it out, because it can be that we have had an error now. So or 55 20, update worker assignment. Yeah. If it is not in, you will run into an error as well. Maybe we have it on the other one, actually. Let's quickly check this one here. View history. No, it is pending, so we created it absolutely correct. Great. So, okay. Now, all of the different departments can now actually go in here, budget plan is assigned to me, and I should see now actually the newest one. So because I am the admin one, and also the new trial is also assigned to me. But now, of course, it is in the department review, which means I can open the worksheet again. Of course, you can add a separate template that in here the things are looking a little bit better or different. And as we said, we didn't transfer those three. We just transferred the thing that that the finance actually said it's fine. And I should be able to say, to override it, so that I say, well, no, I want to have 1,500, and here I want to have 900. And I should be able to publish it then as well. So this means I click in here, publish, and now it's standing here again. But it is published. So this means nothing. This means nothing else than if I open it and if I go to the correct plan, then I should have exactly those figures which I have in here. Yep, perfect. Good. So this means as soon as I'm finished, this here to approve was not copied. Okay. What does it mean if something like this is not copied? Well, that's quite simple. It is just in the budget plan configuration, in the allocation, in the allocation schedule, that we say copy scenario, not across period. He should actually just distribute it as well, and I put JTA, and I need to put it once again from TJTA into TJTA, but within another stage then. So this means stage allocation, and I say, well, also at the same time, at the time of the distribution, at that time he should also copy the scenario. Okay, let's quickly move on, because then we have it in here as well available what the other guy said. So I don't save that. I go to the budget plans, and I can complete, so that then it's fine. And those, I just quickly put it on my user, so I just reassign it to admin, just that I'm able to do it as well. This one here as well, I put it to admin. And now I'm able to complete those as well. And this one here as well. Good. And now we need to quickly wait. Good. So I have, so TJTA, this is fine, this year, of course, I do need to make this step as well. I need to click on complete, otherwise it won't move on. So I need to click in here, and then as soon as I click on complete, so it should be just possible when all the sub or all the child ones are filled out, actually. And someone, he should actually copy now these things in one of those scenarios. Now we see it as soon as the workflow is through. Yep, now, okay. Perfect. So now he copied, actually. So it was also the thing with the stage allocation that we saw that I did before. So now he copied the whole thing into TJTACC. And then again, it is now finance to approve, which needs to be done. And in here, the finance department does have the last thing, the last possibility to say, well, okay, no, I give you just 2 and 1 and 3 and 4 and 5. And then again, publish. and published. You can save it. And F5. And then as soon as he is fine with it, click on approve and approve. And let's just quickly check here. This one is blank, so here as well. The TJRCC needs to be copied as well. So this means nothing else than we need to go in here. It is, yeah, it is always kind of these kind of things. TJRCC needs to be copied as well, respectively aggregated. So aggregate or copy of TJRCC, and it is again an aggregation but as well from 4 to 4, from 4 to 4, and this needs to be done at the same time as the other aggregation. So I'm not sure if this is working or not, but we will see it. Cannot, of course not. Copy of TR. Good, okay. Now, actually, the budget plan should be finished. Totally approved. Yep, perfect. And this one is also not copied, but let's have a look at all the things that happened in here, in this plan. Because in this plan, in the end, you're not allowed to do any changes, but you should have in the end all the things available. And of course, in final, he should actually distribute it over time then in the end. And this one here, TRTCC, is missing. So the final one is also a problem with this one here. So the final, let's say, this one here, cross period from TJACC to TJ finals is fine. At what stage allocate? Okay, this is a stage too early. I need to put it at 7. At 7, allocate to final budget this way. Good. So let's try it once again. Hopefully this time without any problems. So I just quickly go and say, okay, a new one. Historical, as always, no. This time it is working. And then generate. And I say, now I say generate budget plan from budget from another one. So this one here, I can say which one. So I'm going to take the new trial 2, the scenario, not the final, but this one, a historical, no, budget plan to this one. Not a new in here. Yep, and I'm going to say, well, okay, this time it is working. And into the last year's budget, because I'm taking this budget, and I just click on generate as well. And I can say the new one should actually be, so this year's proposal should be 2 times the one from last year. And I can say generate. Good. So now I should have that this time it is working. I can click on the worksheet. And I'm the finance guy now who is going to prepare the budget. So this means last year's budget 1, 2, 3, this time twice as much. This one here is just last year's actuals. So I say now, well, okay, now I give him 500, I give here 600, 700, 800, 900. I click in it, I click on Dynamics AX. I click on publish. I check, yep, it is published. I can save the file because then it is saved in the folder. And then I can say, well, okay, I double click on it. And I see now that this one here is updated based on the one I had in Excel. I click on submit and I say, okay, it is fine. I click on submit and I wait. And I click sometimes on F5. Quickly check what happened. View history. It is pending. It is pending. It is still pending. And still pending. Stopped error. It stopped because budget plan lines could not be distributed. For this budget stage, there are scenario constraints that are not set up with the destination scenario in association with budget plan. Okay. So we did a problem as well. I did something wrong in the distribution of the second one. It actually doesn't make sense at all. It's actually right. Do you know what? I just say I'm going to copy TRJCC into this one across period. And I say here the same fixed lines and everything on the same day. Good. So January 1st. And I say the same. And of course I do the same of with the aggregation. Not that we end up having problems there. The same, and I say in here destination 05204. Good. It's just a copy of those things, actually. I hope that. Is there any kind of. Which one is done at first? We will see. So hopefully I can say, in here now that, okay, he created the plans actually. So, but let's quickly say view history, stopped error, resume. Maybe still have the old version of the thing that he needs to do, but we'll see it. Yeah, now it looks good. Yep, so okay, now he went through. Let's see if he also copied the things in a way how we wanted. So I can actually now go to assigned to me. And I can say, well, this one is assigned to me. I can open the worksheet. It doesn't look like. No, it didn't. Anyhow, I would just need to check how the copy is done. But yeah, I think you understand what's the thing. Maybe you will do it afterwards correctly with the aggregation. So I say here 999. I say here 888. I click on it. I say, well, okay, Dynamics AX publish. It is published. Don't save. F5 and 888999, that's fine. I can click on complete and put it back to the workflow. And once again, I need to do the other two budget plans. So the one for IT, which is not assigned to me. So I just quickly reassign it to myself, and then I can say, well, this is fine. And the same for purchase, where I say it is as well my task to do it. And I say complete and OK. By the way, you have actually always here the possibility to have a look at the budget plan hierarchy so that you see all the different kind of plans. Furthermore, you have also the possibility in the budget planning process to view the budget process status, which means nothing else than you see in here how many of those are in review, how many are approved, and so on. Of course, I've created several times those things because of that there are quite a lot of counts in here. But in the end, normally you start one process just once, and then you just see where is the state in the end, or where are the different kind of places. So yeah, good. So this means we can go back to the budget, and this time it is working. And as before, I need to click on complete and then wait until he copied the things. So I have this one here, I have this one in here, this one is blank, 5 is as well blank, at the moment at least. And maybe he gets now here as well an error because of the new copy that I did, or tried to do. New history, spending. Still pending, stopped. Blah. Select a different scenario to modify budget plan stage. Aggregate does not allow to change line for budget plan scenario. Okay, it makes sense. Makes sense. Make absolutely sense. Ah. So in the scenarios, no, not in the scenarios, in the scenario constraint, I said, you see, it's not easy, and but there will be quite a lot of things where you need to try the things. So in here we have the stage. Maybe that's also the problem before. Yeah, I just put here everything to edit. Then it should work. And this one needs to be editable as well. And also, I need to add here 01016 finance review, and then 06 TJ Finn, and this one is edited, and this one is view. So, okay. No, I can't resume it. Oh, I can resume it. So resume. Try it again. Okay, and it worked. Refresh, saying still pending. But ah, yeah, it is pending. But he copied now the things in 4 and an exact copy into 5 and nothing into 6, right? There are nothing into 6 yet. Perfect. So again, the finance guy has the aggregated budget now, and he can go and say, well, okay, I'm going to. What's the problem? So once again, all budget plans on this one worksheet. Hello. Okay, I don't know why before it didn't work, but I think maybe he had problems with, because the workflow was broken somehow. But now if I do it right now, I haven't done anything. Now it is working actually. So yeah, so good. This means I can say now here my last figures. And if everything is working correctly and is set up correctly, then it should be then distributed in the final one over the time. So this means I'm going to publish it as well, this way. Records failed. You do not have access. We know this error. We click in it and we publish it again. And then it published it. Good. Okay. Don't save or save whatever you want. Good. So the things should be updated in this one here. Absolutely correct. This one should still be blank. And as soon as I say, well, now the budget is approved, AX should copy it in this scenario, 006 TJ final. And he should actually put it quite, he should put quite a lot of things, because the effective date should be then splitted by month. Let's see where the workflow is. Pending. Completed. And if I click here now, F5, then he didn't copy it. I didn't make the distribution. And he didn't had an error. So the distribution didn't work yet. Means there is also stage allocation. Finance approved. Finance approved, allocate to final budget, allocate to final budget, looks fine to me actually. And period key looks also fine to me. Just quickly close it and open it once again. Let's have a look at the worksheet, because in the worksheet you should see now actually the different columns with the different values. But the final is not copied. I'm going to check why it is not copied. I'm not doing the whole process once again. I guess you get the point what I wanted to tell you, and I'm going to quickly check why the final is not distributed, and then this will be then the last thing that that I'm going to show in this tutorial. The rest you just need to try and figure out how it works, how it's working. And as you can see, I'm always glad if you can help me with something, because I'm definitely also will have still some problems with it. Good. Okay, I'm just quickly going to check what's wrong with the distribution. Hooray, I found it out and it is working now, and I learned finally. Now finally I can actually tell you regarding the workflow what is what. So so I need to quickly do something on the workflow actually. So in the end, the department workflow. Actually, the problem was with the copy. Actually, you need to add such a budget planning stage allocation. So the stage transition budget plan is nothing else than he switches the stage from the prior stage to the next stage, and the budget planning stage allocation means nothing else than he is going to execute those allocation schedules and those stage allocations. If it is not in, then it doesn't do it, and this was actually the problem in here. So I just added one at the beginning at the department workflow, so it looks now like this. And on the total workflow, I need to add after the approval to distribute it over time as well, such a budget planning stage allocation. And now it is actually working perfectly fine. So let's quickly do it once again. So I create a new budget based on the actual flow from last year. I click on no. I say we saw I had four things that I needed to do it. So last year's actuals times one. I generate the budget plan. It's generated. I generate one from another budget plan. Replace existing budget plan scenario. That's fine. I'm using this one. I can choose here the actually last year's. Actually, but yeah, I just say the scenario, so in the end it would be the final one. I say no. I say here, of course, the really working seven. I say here last year's budget. I say generate, and I say, for example, the new budget should be based on the actuals times 1.25. So I say again here no. I say document number, the new one, and I say here this one to approve, so just as a proposal 1.25, and I click on generate. Good, now I have in the budget plans from my organization, I see here really working seven, so I can go and click and open the worksheet. Perfect. I can say, well, no, I want to amend here this one to 7,000, this one to 8,000, this one to 9,000, this one to 10,000, and this one to 11,000. And I can go and publish it. And it is published. Perfect. I can open it. And I can have here a look at the different scenarios, and then I have in here, and I can say that's fine. I can submit it. Good. I can go out and budget plans assigned to me. Somewhere there should be a new one, or basically in here just all which are actually for you, but I go to all budget plans just to see what happened. So really working 7 is now in the aggregated stage. I have one which is directly assigned to me, so the admin one. I can open the worksheet. Perfectly fine. I just see those two. That's exactly what I wanted. And I can say, well, no, I want to have here 9,000, here 10,000. I can go and say again, okay, publish. It published it. I can quickly open it to check it. That's fine. I can say complete. And those two I need to, of course, because it's not on, it's not assigned to me. I need to assign it first to me. This one here as well. Just quickly assign it to me, reassign F5, and I just say yes, those are fine. And by the way, if I try to complete this one while not all childs are finished, I can actually not do it, because then you get here the message that there are associated budget plans which needs to be completed at first. Good, and now it's quickly await and clicking F5 until those three are approved. Yep, now they are approved, which means now I can say, well, okay, the budgeting from the different departments are finished. As I said, on the process, if you just have one, you would see how many of them are finished and who is not yet. Good. So now I need to wait until the status here, or the stage change from aggregated to finance review. So still clicking on F5. He should go through quite soon, because it is every, yep, now finance review. Perfect, which means now he should actually copy all the things back in. So if I can now click again on the worksheet, and I should see now all the columns. Perfectly fine. So this is the thing that that were changed, for example. So I changed this amount here, and on the admin one I changed it, so I always see the whole history, last year's actual, last year's budget. The thing that the finance department said proposed, the one that the cost center wanted, and now I have the possibility here as a finance guy to say, well, no, I give you, I don't know why, but I give you more, 24,000, and I give you just 120, 360, and 480. And then again, I can go and publish it. And it is published, which means nothing else than, I have here the different scenarios where which I can have a look at. Yep, and as soon as I'm finished, I can say, at the moment, by the way, this one is blank. And as soon as I say, well, now I'm going to approve it, because I've added a new budget plan stage allocation, he will run the distribution now as well. So I just need to quickly wait until the status changed to finance approved. And then we can finally go to the last step that we need to do. The transfer from the budget plan to the budget entry, so that you can also make kind of analysis and comparison between the budgeting and the general ledger, for example, for this year. So finance approved, which means now in the worksheet, which I open, I should see actually all four columns. Yep, and of course in here exactly the same amount as the finance approved, but with the difference, if I open it now and if I go here to TJ Final, then you see that he actually split the whole amount, that he split the whole amount here, for example, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10 into the different months. Perfect. So this means nothing else than the last step is then to do the generate budget register entries. Actually, nothing else than bring it from the budget plans to the budget register entries. So I can say which one it is, who is the responsible, so the source in the end, so the newest one which worked, so the really working, and the scenario, of course, the final, and the target is the budget model standard which we've created with the budget code or need original budget. You can use any kind of thing, yeah. And yeah, don't aggregate the lines. And this means if I click now on generate, then they were created, and I have in here now my budget in a draft mode. Now the basic budgeting starts actually, but I have here now all the lines in here, and I can click update budget balances and okay, and it is posted, and now we have it actually in there in the budgeting module, and we can do comparisons either over the management reporter or over financial statements if you're kind of old-fashioned, and of course as well if I would look here on the main account then, and for example run an account statement where you want to see the budget, and when I say okay, of course main account, it is turning and turning and turning and loading and loading. And yeah, then you see that you have actually in here those amounts available on the accounts. Good. So I just quickly show you once again the parameters that I've added. Yeah, I actually did here nothing. I did here as well nothing. In stages, I also did nothing more than before. In the workflow, actually, as well, not. But in the scenario constraints, some of them I put edit, some view. But you can actually try it what to do because just the workflow would just break. And in the end, yeah, you anyways need to test it. The allocation schedules, I made some amendments in here. Yep, with the copy. The copy here actually, and this one here as well. In the stage allocations, I also make a small one that I put it here. That's the finance review, and I think here distributed. Yep. Priority, nothing. Folders, nothing. And template as well, nothing. And in the budget planning process, I did as well nothing. As I said, if you want to make a second kind of budget, revenue or project budget, you just need to create a new budget planning process, and then you can do it however you want. Good. As you can see, it was quite harsh, the whole thing, but in the end, it is working. And as I said, I also never set it up before. I just, as I needed quite some time to get at least a little bit into it. And now, just with try and error, it worked somehow. I'm always happy if you have any kind of inputs, then please just post onto my channel. I'm also always glad and happy if you can give me some hints or some things that I can do better. Good. So I wish you a nice evening and all the best. Thank you for watching this video.